arch of the Etheria.
Hi all and welcome. This will be part 6 to the series Occult Wellington. It's been months since I produced part 5. Enjoy. This is the historic St. Paul's Church, built in 1866 here in Wellington. And we'll have a look inside. Now, this would be a bell tower right here, and you have the ropes for the bell tower and various windows. Now, it's built out of wood, and yeah, construction started I think in 1866 or thereabouts. The ambience of this church is notable. It's a very calming place to be in. It has a very calm ambience about it. Now, on entry, I felt it. I felt this real calmness within the church, and I haven't felt this, or this was the strongest that I've ever felt it anywhere. So a real vibe there. So within the church, I came across some writing to do with it. Now, this was after I'd experienced it, and in a way, I was kind of unsurprised. So under the title, Some Unexpected Magic. Now, with the calming of churches, that's perhaps why there are candles there. They bring in the fire, and they draw in the fire elementals, and they help to calm churches as well. But there was a calmness within this church, and if we read from the quote here, the quietude and exaltation of the human spirit that every sensitive person may feel, be he churchman or not. So I definitely felt it within this old wooden church. Now, we're in Wellington, and we're in a wooden building, a wooden structure. Now, on this note, there is a reason for doing this, and that is that the wood may hold up to earthquakes. But apart from that, we have the account from Alec Newold, where he was in Wellington also, and talked about going to an occult event under blindfold and all the rest of it, and going into a wooden building within Wellington, also a building that was completely wooden. And by the way, there are a few things that Alec Newold said that many, probably of you out there, would not pick up on. You have to do your reading. You have the font right here, and the thing I like about this font is that you have the structure atop the font, the architectural structure atop the font, and because that's what it would be part of. It's part of that central pillar, but it's also part of a wider structure of etheric light. Just having a look along this way here, having a look at the roof and up to the temple of the church. Now, going through these churches, within these churches you have foliage, and if this is the body of the person, you have the foliage actually running through the person, if you will. If this is the human body and we are inside it, you have the foliage kind of running through the human body. You could think of it like that. Now, this participant right here with the hand signal going up in the archway with the foliage, the fleur-de-lis right here, and going up, this consciousness of being within the tree of life and actually being the tree of life. Now, over here, I'll just do a bit of a look here. Interesting if we can pick up the little face within that structure right there. But coming this way, we have this lectern here, and you can see the eagle here of Scorpio right on there with the with that ring around the neck, and you'll see that ring. Now, this is an exceptional example. You have the basic four around the one, and you have the what I would suggest is representative of orbs right here, with spirits in the orbs, strangely enough. So you have the representation around here of the four signs, the four fixed signs of the zodiac, with the lion, the bull, the man, and it would be represented on both sides. So this would be Taurus, for example, on this part here, this quarter of it, and then coming around this way, just having your eagle right there, and then back around to Leo the lion right here, with the energies going up, the four around the one here also. Now, I don't often see this, but here we have, instead of the lion's paw coming out, we have the whole lion right there. So, and that would perhaps be a shape-shifted cherubim emerging out of the central pillar in this case. In this window, we have the two assisting angels or cherubim with music and vibration sending energy, I would suggest, to the central figure right there, and assisting with the consciousness of the central figure. Now, that motif, we can see that motif around in the head window of the church also, where we can see Christ figure and the male and female either side, the three right there with those three doorways, also the three archways. So very interesting. It's represented with the candles as well, I would suggest, with the cross in the center. There's the three steps up the chakras. You see that in Masonic halls, and there you see the cross right there. And notice the configuration of the cross on the larger cross. We'll now have a look around this way. We'll just take a bit of... Some of the detail in the woodwork here is exceptional, but the next thing I'd like to have a look at is the pulpit right here. And this is a very old piece of this church, and you have the participants, I would suggest, around the outside here, and the priest would be in the center, the mage in the center. So it's magic circle like in a way, and that would be the area up here where the mage would conduct the sermons from. The interesting thing about this is that the consciousness of these people, of these participants here, they don't sort of join to the floor. It's like they're elevated in a position in space, if you will, in an interdimensional position within their consciousness. The mage would stand on the central pillar, and it's possibly a representation of the situation for the mage in the center in regards to the assisting, what are perhaps assisting participants on the outside of this particular configuration. So we're looking at this face up here within Old St. Paul's Church in Wellington, and you will notice that you don't have the body there. It's as if, perhaps, that the body has dissolved away.
It's as if, perhaps, that the body has dissolved away.
Earlier in the series, we saw the Cathedral of St. Paul also, which is situated in Wellington, and there you can see what I would suggest is the Christ figure, kind of the physical dissolving, if you will, dissolving into light. further within this graphic from the collective 777, you can see the figure in the center there with the legs dissolving away also, I would suspect. Interestingly, you have the green chakra perhaps situated in the tummy area. A reference to the heart chakra.
The heart chakra.
The etheric magnetic heart chakra.
Dissolve, coagulate.
Get with the program.
Dissolve, coagulate, dissolve, 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 dissolve.
I've talked about the notion of dissolve before.
Dissolve. Dissolve. The heart chakra.
Occultists boldly show it, but do you notice it?
I've talked about the notion of dissolve before.
Let's carry on. Gandhi travelling right there. The train station of Wellington right here. And we'll have a quick look inside. You can see the archway there, and that light would actually be where the central pillar is represented inside. Just noticing here that this building was opened on the 19th day of June 1937. This would be the winter solstice for the southern hemisphere. Three steps going up. Up the chakras. The royals are always in on this sort of stuff. Through, across the water of fire and water. The barrier of the chicken floor. And this would be the central pillar represented right here with the light and the ceiling and so forth. Representative of the Masonic edifice with the kind of fasci arrangement up there as part of that central pillar configuration. There's a wider look at the edifice. Dimension data, of course, you would have what is perhaps an interdimensional representation within there. This National Mutual Life Association building of Australasia over here. Within there are lions coming out and numerous kind of grotesque green men in a way across the face of the building. Very elaborate building. And then just over this side of the road here, we have this old AMP building, and you have the cornucopias up here in that kind of three configuration, and the kind of bull representation here. And you can see representation of this elsewhere. It's quite ancient, with the shields and so forth, and the very elaborate doorway through here with the keystone and the flower, the kind of flowers in a way, the portals going out from that in a way, from the participant in the center. You have the goddess in the center here, and within the building there are cherubim emanating out of the foliage. There are the Corinthian pillars with the swastika style motifs within there, and the griffins also within here, the two griffins, which would perhaps be shape-shifted cherubim also. So quite an elaborate building. Just before we wrap up, earlier on in this video series, I made mention of going up a building trying to find a pyramid, but I actually went up the wrong building. It was another library. But anyway, this is the National Library here, and it has that pyramid of light atop it. Now, I'm familiar and have been for quite a while, probably years, of the notion of a pentagram within the street plan within Wellington. So this would be it here. I'm certainly not convinced. This will do. This concludes the series Occult Wellington. I hope you enjoyed it.